thought we should take a look at one more example of determining limits analytically. Here we have a rational function that does not simplify. So we have the limit as x approaches 4 of 1 over x minus 2. Well, this function is continuous except at the value of x equals 2. So as we approach positive 4 from the left and from the right, it would be continuous on an open interval containing 4. Therefore, we could determine this limit by performing direct substitution. By replacing x with 4, we'll have 1 over 4 minus 2, which is equal to 1/2. And to get a better idea of exactly what's happening here, I provided the graph. And notice that here's an open interval containing 4. And as we approach 4 from the left and from the right, we are approaching this point right here where the function value would be equal to f of 4, which allows us to determine this limit by performing direct substitution. For the second example, we have the limit as x approaches positive 2 of 1 over x minus 2. And if we try to perform direct substitution, notice that we have a denominator of 0, and therefore the function is undefined at x equals 2. So for this one, without looking at the graph, I want to try to determine the left-sided and right-sided limit separately. And then we'll verify them graphically. One thing to notice right away is as we approach 2, whether from the left or right, the denominator is approaching 0. So we have a constant 1 divided by a smaller and smaller number. So as we approach 2 from the positive side, notice how our denominator is still approaching 0, but it'll always be a positive value. So if we have 1 divided by a really small positive value, we would actually be approaching positive infinity. And for the limit as x approaches 2 from the left, or the negative side, notice how our denominator is always going to be negative because x is just a little bit less than 2. So if we have 1 divided by a number that's very close to 0 but negative, this limit is going to approach negative infinity. Of course, both of these don't exist. Now, even though the idea here is to determine these limits analytically, let's go ahead and enhance our learning by taking a look at it graphically as well. So we're approaching x equals 2, so we're approaching this vertical line here from both the left and the right. So notice how as we approach 2 from the positive side or right side, the function values increase without bound here. And as we approach positive 2 from the left or negative side, notice how the function values decrease without bound. So here's our limit that's approaching positive infinity, and here's our limit that's approaching negative infinity. Which means the limit as x approaches 2 of 1 divided by x minus 2, of course, doesn't exist. So the more we can do analytically, the better off we're going to be when determining limits, but it is always nice to verify our work graphically just to be sure. I hope this was helpful.